something like this every Thursday. It won't be Legos when we're done. It'll be something different. So, Power Car, our title. And Charlie looked right at the ramp right away. And Charlie, what did you tell me when you walked in and looked at that ramp?
Why is the star at the top of the end?
Why is the star at the bottom? What do you think?
So the car can go up.
Nelson, what'd you say? Speak up.
So the car can go up.
So the car can go uphill. How on earth is it going to go uphill? Okay, so we're building a power car. That is our main goal. That's what we're constructing today. You guys are engineers, you're constructing a power car. So our objective, our focus, someone read my first one for me. Hands up. Go ahead, Rob Green.
Students will construct a power car that climbs uphill.
Charlie saw it and knew right away. Power car that climbs uphill. Second one. Go ahead, Cabana.
Which modified version of the power car is the fastest uphill?
And why? So modified, what does that word mean again? We talked about it. Modified, which modified version of the power car? What does modified mean? What are we going to do? What do you think? Which modified version of the power car? Use your context clues. What does modified mean? Customize, okay, someone add to it. Which modified version? What'd you say?
Upgrade.
Upgrade, okay. So we're making a power car and we're gonna modify it a couple times.
Upgrade. Change.
Change it, definitely. You guys are gonna find out all these different things. We're gonna change our tire size, we're gonna change our weight, we're gonna change our gear ratio, you guys, and it's really gonna be interesting today. So a couple vocab words. Friction, you guys, we talked about it. It is the force resisting the relative motion of solid surfaces, fluid layers, and material elements sliding against each other. Go like this with your hands. Friction, right? So how's friction gonna come into play today when we're going uphill? Think about that. Think about what you feel, it warms you up. How's friction coming into play? All right, our next vocab word, I'm not gonna read it because we know what it is. Someone tell me what a ratio is. What is a ratio? Someone tell me. Someone tell me what a ratio is. Someone tell me what a ratio is. It's a relationship between what?
Two numbers.
It compares two quantities. You guys, get used to the cameras. Wake up. Now. We're talking about gears. Now, gears are very important because we're going to get our ratio from our gears today. And your gears are going to play a big factor in how fast your car goes uphill. So, gears are your tooth wheels, you guys, all your tooth little Lego pieces. Those are your gears, you guys. They work together in the relations of the speed of your car and your wheel, you guys. And then it counterbalances a weight that balances out another. Your connection. How can you make a power car that moves uphill? So once again, we have Jack and Jill here, guys. Sorry, a little loud. So they're struggling. They're not going uphill. Work together, collaborate, put their heads together. Some gears. Some gears, some tires. They had a problem. They couldn't get uphill. They came to a solution. They didn't really show you what it was there. So, your problem is you have to get uphill. Today, you have to build a car that travels uphill. So, has anyone ever skateboarded uphill?
No.
Raise your hand. Ran up a hill. You almost feel like you're Johnny Bravo when you're running uphill, all your weight goes backwards, right? Or when you're skating uphill, you're almost leaning back when you're going. You all have to lean all of your weight forward over your front foot.
I fell on the hill once.
Exactly. And when you're going downhill, it's the inverse. It's the exact opposite. It's like you're falling forward. So, we need to make our car to go uphill, right? Those of you that skateboarded uphill, you know it's not easy. You have to exert a lot of energy to get uphill. So, here's our construct. Our second C, what we're building. This is your goal. You're engineering a power car. All your booklets are in there. It's 11A and 11B. 2, page 9, step 10. After your construct phase, you guys, when you are done, you will come to the back station, to the contemplate station, where we will do all of our investigating, our math today. So, here are your questions you're going to think. Which is the fastest uphill power car? So, you guys are going to predict first, and then test second, you guys. Now, here's your lab sheet pretty much. If you notice, you have 4 different modified parts on your lab sheet. You're going to predict first how quick it's going to travel. So your first prediction, you guys, is going to be totally a shot in the dark. You haven't done it before. You're going to predict, give me an educated guess, how long it's going to take to travel up that big ramp.
20 minutes.
That's, you think that's your prediction. Then the test, you'll go back, we'll modify, predict, test. And then when we continue, you guys, our fourth C, we're going to up the height. We're going to add more weight. We're going to switch our axles, all the above. Are you guys ready to start?
Yes, sir.
So, let me go to the construct seat. All of book 11A and 11B. You guys make, before you open, listen up. Remember how small these pieces are. Remember that for you to be successful, you have to work collaboratively with your partner. Remember, you guys, that pieces will go everywhere. Be super careful. Use your top as a canister to catch them, and you may begin. Book 11A and book 11B. I'm going to put some music on and we'll start. So that piece is an area of 5. 1 by 5. You got those 4? Now look where they're going. Matthew, your mat flat guys, go right in. See? Looks like in the top and the bottom one. Which took projection right in the middle. 1 by 5, look. It's 1 by 1, 2, 3, 4. Nope, that's not even it. 1 by 5, right here, buddy. And you need 2 of them. That ratio 1 to 1 for every 1 picture, it'll match it perfectly. Perfect. So look, why don't you do this one? It's in that set. You can feed that through just like that. That ratio means for that picture, it'll match exactly. Yep.
Look at the lost and found, Veronica. Yep. Is it in there? I think there's a piece in there.
Keep it off, yep. So, now, 1 to 1, that ratio means what? For every 1 picture, it's going to match exactly. So, great one. Veronica, we need 1. One to 1, good. I want to hear your math terms, you guys. I need a 1 by 4. I need a 2 by 8. Let me hear your math terms. Remember, whenever you see that picture, that means you have a ratio, a direct comparison.
Yeah.
probably put the wrong one.
Guys, when you get to 11B, step 5 and 6, I really want you to know.
So,
you're saying it's going to take a minute to travel, right? Now, if it's 8 feet wide, long you guys, you win. Let's do it. So, let's test your prediction. Hold up. So start right there. And your prediction. You said 1 minute?
I cut this long ways last night, which means now it's 2 feet wide and 8 feet high, right? So, you're saying it's going to take a minute to travel up, right? Now, if it's 8 feet wide, long, you guys, let's do it. So, let's test your prediction. Hold up. You'll start right there.
That was not 1 minute.
I got 5 seconds.
110. 5 and 110. All right, so we'll do 3 trials real quick. That was your prediction, exact.
No, I'm about to dirty.
5.1.
Oh, 3 seconds?
Yep. So it was 3.8. 3.8. We'll do one more to get our average.
He was better
than 2 minutes too. 3.38. So now here's the deal. Write down these three numbers, grab a calculator, add them up, find the average, and then you go back, I'll put the slide up, now you're going to modify, you're going to change your little gears, and you're going to see what it does. So, write these three down on your paper, go back, test it, and go modify. So, Rob Green, you guys are going to change it, you're going to change your gears inside there, your little teeth, you see these two? And you're going to see what happens, does it go faster or slower?
It's going to go slower, slower.
Let me put that slide up for you, 1 second, Jada. Okay, 3.8. We're gonna get a couple of more accurate reading, a better trial. So, ready? Point six. Need help? 1 second, buddy. Go ahead. Ready? Hold up. Here we go. All right, go. Don't let it go away. 3.8 and 3.6. Let me tell you a little trick when you're finding the average. If you add all these up, divide by 3. Look how this is the same, this is the same, this is 2 less. If you add them all up and divide by 3, your average is going to be 3.7 seconds. Now, you're going to switch your gears, your little teeth there. Instead of, there's 16 little ones away, or your gears, there's 16 little teeth, so now you're going to put one on. And now you're just putting on bigger tires. I'm sorry, not switching your gear. And then we'll switch your gear. All right, so go back and we'll do your second test. Anyone else ready to test?
I need help.
We modify the car and put on bigger tires, and this is what we think is going to happen. So what do you think is going to happen?
I think it's going to be slower.
We should put up bigger tires and bring it slower.
Slower? Savannah, what do you think is going to happen?
It's going to be slower.
Why?
Because the wheels are bigger.
Wheels are bigger? So I thought bigger tires meant bigger circumference, they can travel longer.
No, but it can travel more, but it's slower.
Tell me why.
Say if you have like a toy
Toyota, like a Toyota, all right. And Japanese.
Then, and then you drive it, and then it goes really, really fast. If you get like, maybe like a Range Rover,
I think it's because since the tires are a bit more smoother, because the other ones had like were a bit jagged, so
okay,
that it won't
rated.
Be able, yeah, it won't really have
much grip.
Yeah,
so it'll be more friction.
Yeah. All
right. So why don't you guys go to the camera and tell them this is our second trial. We modified our cart with bigger tires. So you're gonna say we modified our cart with bigger tires. You got it. Go ahead. Go ahead. Okay, guys. So write it down and hold your car. Show them your car.
The first trial.
So your actual was 3.6.
All right.
Okay. We modified our car, and this is our second trial.
And what'd you do to modify it?
We changed the wheels.
So what do you think is gonna happen now? You put on bigger wheels.
It's gonna go slower.
Slower. Both agree. Any reason why?
Because the tires might be a bit more smoother, so then it won't have enough grip.
Less friction?
Yeah.
Not as much grip? Let's test it. Let's see. So your first one was 4 seconds? Second attempt. Ready? Don't want to fall. Well, I'm not even doing it, Tom, because it didn't make it to the top. So I'm going to reset that.
Robert.
And we're just going to do one trial. We're not going to find an average, so you can do the other test. All right? So, Rob Green, we're just doing one trial because we're running out of time.
Ready?
Oh, I still have
it.
No. It's amazing.
I'm going to make it!
Oh, we are close.
8.05, so that's 8 and 0 tenths. So what is that as a decimal? Or what is that as a fraction?
8.05.
8.5? No.
8 and 5 over what place value?
5 over 100.
That's your 100 plus, so 5 over 100. So write it as a fraction or a decimal. 8.05, 8 and 5 hundredths.
So we're saying you
modify. Yeah, go ahead, you're doing one trial. You want to go to the camera too, Tom? Or you do the next one, because you're ahead. You'll do the gear one. Go ahead. Just test it. I'll be right there, Ange. Charlie, you're next. They're right in front of you. We're just doing one trial, so now we have a line.
How much time do we have?
It's 9:30, so we got to clean up, unfortunately, in like 10 minutes. Go ahead. Savannah, get right to that so we can get the, change the gears in and see what happens.
What's the next page?
So, it's right up there. So you're the cart C, yep. So you guys were 6.12. What is that as a fraction,
6.12? 6.12.
As a fraction. So what place value in?
100.
100, so it's 6 and 12 over?
100.
6 and 12 over 100, you girls remember that?
Yeah.
All right. Go ahead, go to the next one so you can do your third trial. It's right there. So you go to page 11, step 12, Jada. B, same bit, book you're running with. All right, you girls predicted this one? Obviously you saw them. It looks like it's going slower, right? So, hold on, let me get time. Ready? Hit it. Whoa, what'd you give it, a jump start right there? I gotta do one more try. Just let it go with the power. Ready? One more time. I got 4.55. 4.55. What is that as a fraction? 455 over 100. Good job. Go, it's page 11, step 12.